It's been a tough year for the Great Barrier Reef. Over summer, the reef suffered one of the most widespread and serious bleaching events on record, and two cyclones, one of which caused heavy flooding. The AIMS long-term monitoring team were in the water doing our annual surveys before and during this challenging period. Our annual update focuses on the percentage of live coral cover, which is a very common reef indicator. We measure this using a quick and efficient technique that allows us to visit as many reefs as possible each year. Over the last 15 years, we've seen coral cover reach its lowest levels because of crown of thorns starfish, cyclones, and particularly mass coral bleaching events. But we've also seen amazing recovery, with coral cover reaching the highest levels we've ever recorded in the northern and central regions of the Great Barrier Reef. Coral cover has remained high over the last few years, and our results this year show that these levels have persisted, increasing slightly from last year. This is good news, but what about that tough summer? That warrants an explanation.
Firstly, the effects of this summer's elevated heat stress are still playing out. It can take months for corals to either recover or die, and will take a while for the full effects of this summer's bleaching to be known. Secondly, most of our surveys were done prior to elevated heat stress causing widespread coral bleaching. Surveys were also done during the event, and bleached coral, while severely stressed, is recorded as live coral cover. Thirdly, most surveys were done prior to the passage of the two cyclones across the reef. So this year's survey's results don't yet reflect the effects of these summer events on coral cover, but they do provide a robust reference period from which to assess reef condition in the upcoming season.
Our team surveyed 94 reefs over 120 days at sea and recorded big differences in coral cover among reefs. In the northern region, coral cover increased slightly to a regional high. This region avoided cyclones this summer, but experienced varied amounts of heat stress. All our surveys in this region were completed before the heat stress set in, and the data will provide a great reference point against which we can measure the impacts of bleaching following our next round of surveys. Coral cover in the central region also increased to a regional high before many reefs were struck by cyclones Jasper and Kirrily, and also varying amounts of heat stress. Surveys off Townsville after Cyclone Kirrily showed that several reefs were damaged from the storm, while others escaped relatively unscathed. Coral cover in the south also increased slightly before experiencing prolonged elevated heat stress. Some areas faced the highest heat exposure ever experienced on the reef. Some corals were already beginning to die because of the heat stress in this region, while a persistent crown of thorns outbreak remains in the swains.
The 2024 mass coral bleaching event was the fifth since 2016. However, we will need to wait for the end of the surveys next season before we understand the full impact of this event on the Great Barrier Reef. Increases in coral cover can quickly be reversed by large-scale disturbances, such as the marine heatwave we've seen this summer. But we can't predict how high the mortality from this event is going to be. Coral bleaching is a stress response, and mass coral bleachings are a modern phenomenon. So while coral cover was high on the Great Barrier Reef prior to the summer, it doesn't mean that all is fine. The reef still faces pressure from multiple sources, and the increasing frequency and severity of these events poses a severe threat to its future.
Global efforts to reduce greenhouse gas emissions are needed to protect reefs into the future. And the development of science-based interventions are also important to help corals adapt and recover from climate change. Our long-term monitoring team will be back in the water in September to resurvey the reef, and this will begin to reveal the impacts from this summer.